Hi friends, welcome you. I will take up, we have done one problem on flange coupling in the previous video. I am taking up another problem. I have selected problem number 3 from the question bank. Here the problem says like this: design a cast iron flange coupling for a mild steel shaft transmitting 90 kilowatt, that is the power is 90 kilowatt at 250 rpm, that is the speed 250 rpm. It is given the allowable shear stress in the shaft, that is tau for shaft, is 40 MPa, 40 MPa, and the angle of twist is not to exceed 1 degree, that is theta is 1 degree, in a length of 20 diameters, L is equal to 20 d. The allowable shear stress in the bolts, allowable shear stress in the bolt, tau bolt is 30 MPa or 30 Newton per mm square. They have not given the crushing and shear stress for key. Now we will assume that key and shaft are made of same material, we can assume. But crushing stress we will take as, the crushing stress for key, allowable crushing stress for key, we will take as say 80 Newton per mm square or 80 MPa. We'll assume that. They have not given one more thing, that is G, modulus of rigidity, C or G. I'll take it as 0.84 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per mm square. I have assumed. The allowable shear stress for the muff and flange, that is for cast iron, allowable shear stress for cast iron is also not given. We'll assume it as, generally it is 10 to 20 Newton per mm square. I will assume it as 15 Newton per mm square. If it is not given, we can assume these values, they are the normal values. I have taken this problem. I have selected this problem. We will take up this, work out this. Now, first again, we have to design the shaft. Design of shaft. Always in a coupling problem, the first thing that we design is the shaft. To design the shaft, you require torque. So, T is equal to 9.55 P by N into 10 to the power of 6 Newton millimeter. So that will be 9.55 into 90 divided by 250 into 10 to the power of 6. That works out to 9.55 into 90 divided by 250, it works out to 3.438. We'll take it as 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6, no problem, Newton millimeter. Now, nothing is said to increase this torque or anything. So, this itself will be the maximum torque. This itself will be the mean torque and same will be the maximum torque. So now, D is to be found out. Here, they have given shear stress, they have also given theta, L, and G was not given, I have assumed, because they want us to design it by both strength basis and rigidity basis. We have not done such problem in shafts also, so I have taken this problem. A, design of shaft, on strength basis, strength basis means I have to take this one. T by J is equal to tau by R. Now here, if you simplify this, you will get D is equal to 16T, or T max divided by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3. This will be the formula in the case of solid shaft, because J is pi D to the power of 4 by 32 and R is D by 2. So if you substitute those here and simplify, you are going to get this. So 16 into T max is 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into, this is shaft, tau shaft. Tau shaft is 40. So 40 whole to the power of 1 by 3. So 16 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 40 will give me something, cube root of this, cube root of answer 76.38 mm I got. Now you need not adopt it now, we need not adopt it, we'll see what we get when we design it by rigidity basis. Design of shaft on rigidity basis. Here the formula to be used is theta is equal to 584 TL divided by GRC into D to the power of 4. So many degrees, theta in degrees. Now D to the power of 4 will be 584, or I'll do one thing, I'll take it, substitute it like this only. So theta is given as 1 degree, 1 is equal to 584, T is 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into L is 20 diameters, means 20 times dia, not this dia, whatever dia you are getting, 20 times that, divided by 0.84 into 10 to the power of 5 into D to the power of 4. So here what will happen is 1D will get cancelled, D cube is left. So D will be equal to 584 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into 20, that D is gone, divided by 0.84 into 10 to the power of 5 into theta, that is 1. This 1 will come here, this D will go there, whole to the power of, this is D cube, so D will be equal to cube root of that. So now here also again you find D, 584 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into 20 divided by 0.84 divided by 10 to the power of 5 divided by 1, means you can leave it, equals 584 into 3.5 into 10 raised to 6 into 20 divided by 0.84 divided by 10 to the power of 5 equals, I got something, cube root of this, cube root of answer will give me 78. D is equal to 78.65 mm, almost the same, but sometimes there can be difference. I think the next available standard size is 80, whether it is 76 point something or 78 point something, you have to adopt 80 only. So adopt D as 80 mm. So now, here afterwards, wherever we get D, small d, that is dia of shaft, it will be 80 mm. Now next, what you have to do is you have to design the key. This finishes design of shaft. You have to design the key. So design the key means you have to find out design of key. Width and thickness of key you will get from this table here. For 80 mm up to 85, width is 25 mm, this is 25 mm and thickness of the key is 14 mm. Length of each key will be equal to 1.5D. That is 1.5 into 80, that is 120 mm. Then immediately the same procedure, check for induced stresses in key. Induced stresses in key. So two stresses are to be found out. One is shear stress. Shear stress in the key, 2 into T max divided by DLW. So 2 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6. D is 80, L is 120, width is 25, right? 25 mm. So substitute, take the calculator, find it out. 2 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 80 divided by 120 divided by 25 equals 29.16. 29.16 or 17 Newton per mm square. Now, if I have assumed shaft and key are of same material, so the permissible stress is 40 MPa. This is 29 point something, so it is less than that. Next, crushing stress in the key. Crushing stress in the key. For finding crushing stress, the formula is crushing stress in the key is 40 divided by DLT. So 4 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 80 into 120 into this is 14. So that works out to 4 multiplied by 3.5 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 divided by 80 divided by 120 divided by 14 will give me 104.16 Newton per mm square. I have taken it as, they have not given it, I have taken it as 80, so it is coming more than 80, so I have to alter this dimension. You have to write that it is not safe. So you have to make it, say I'll make this 150. Let us see what will happen. 4 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 80 divided by 150 divided by 14. It will be 83.3. And now I'll take this as 90 here. If I take it as 90, now if I make it 150, it will be, you have to write readopted L as 150 Newton per mm, 150 mm. Length of the key is 150 mm. It is readopted from 120. Then you have to substitute. You get this as 83.3 Newton per mm square. So now you say that it is safe because the permissible value is 90 MPa, 90 megapascals, and the induced value is 83.3. It is less than that. Therefore, the design is safe. So that finishes the design of key. And next we have to design the flanges and bolts. As usual, as we did in the previous problem, I took this problem because here the shaft is to be designed on both strength and rigidity basis, which we had not done in earlier problems. Therefore, I wanted to do this problem. Now, a design of flanges, capital D is 2D, our D is 80 mm, so 2 into 80, that is 160 mm, L is, length of the hub is 1.5D, that is 1.5 into 80, that is 120 mm, thickness of flange is 0.5D, that is 0.5 into 80, that is 40 mm. He has not said whether it is protected or unprotected. We'll assume that it is unprotected type. So protective rim is not necessary. Bolt circle dia, D1 is 3D, that is 3 into 80, that is 240 mm. Outer dia of the flanges, 4D, that is 4 into 80, 320 mm. Then number of bolts N is 4, because D is more than 40, less than 100 mm. So the value of D is between 40 and 100 mm. Therefore N is 4. Now check for induced stresses in flanges. There are two, flange and hub. Now hub, the formula is 16 T max divided by pi capital D cube into 1 minus k to the power of 4. K will be 0.5, 16 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi into, this is 160, right? 160 cube into 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4. This works out to 0.9375. So take the calculator. 16 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 160 cube, 160 to the power of 3 divided by 0.9375. It works out to 7.8 Newton per mm square. It is less than, I have assumed it as, it was not given, I have taken it as 15 Newton per mm square. It is less than that. Now tau flange also we can find out, 2t divided by pi d square into tf. So 2 into 3.5 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi into d square, 160 square into tf is 40. So that works out to 2 into 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi divided by 160 square divided by 40. That will be 2.17 Newton per mm square. So now both these are less than 15 Newton per mm square. So you have to write, therefore design is safe. After that, bolt diameter, bolt diameter, design of bolt, design of bolts. You have to find out the dia of bolt. For dia of bolt, the formula is T is equal to N into pi d 1 square by 4 into tau bolt into d 1 by 2. So d 1 will be equal to root of T into 4 into 2, square root of T into 4 into 2 divided by N into pi into tau bolt into d 1. So T is 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into 4 into 2, N is 4 into pi, bolt stress is 30 into D1 is 3D, that is 240. Pitch circle dia, 3.5 into 10 to the power of 6 into 4 into 2 divided by 4 divided by pi divided by 30 divided by 240 gives me 309 point something. Square root of answer gives me 17.59 mm, say 18 mm. So therefore you can write M18 bolts are to be used. M18 bolts are to be used. This is the answer. So we have worked out this two problems on flange coupling. I hope you have understood it. The procedure remains the same. The values keep changing, that's all. These values get changing, otherwise the procedure remains the same.